9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
She's coming in concert. It's an evening with Amy Grant. A night of inspiration, stories, songs, and more. It's an evening with Amy Grant.
We've been waiting a long time for this moment. Are you ready? Beginning this fall, the pack is back.
Wow, what a year it's been. I'm so glad you are here. There's an old adage in theater, and that adage is that the show must go on. And I'm thrilled to say now that the show and the shows go on because of the way this community came together to ensure the Performing Arts Center would emerge strong post-pandemic. Our donors continue to contribute. Our members continue to sign up. Our government officials look for ways to support us through available funds. Our staff remain dedicated to your Performing Arts Center, constantly changing plans and coming up with new strategies. You know, not everything was bad. We tried our first ever drive-in theater experience, which gave us the inspiration for this event tonight. I hope it's not raining. Our education series continued virtually, and we did Arttober Live, as well as the Philharmonic performances on our stage. Meanwhile, our trustees continued to invest in our facilities. We upgraded the stage lighting system to LEDs with new controlling boards and other mechanicals. Their continued support of the campus and these facilities makes Kent State University of Tuscarawas the jewel that it is. We're not only surviving but thriving due to our community efforts. I thank everyone for your dedication to our center. Now, sit back, enjoy the show, and, well, if I've learned anything this year, it is that life is a cabaret. So now I'll introduce you to my old chum, David Mitchell.
The seats behind me have been empty for far too long. At the Performing Arts Center, we exist to bring people together and to build community. It's time to get back to what we do best. We can't wait to welcome you back and to bring you exciting live experiences. In addition to our season of shows, it is our distinct pleasure to have the Tuscarawas Philharmonic as a resident company at the Performing Arts Center. And we're always excited to have them included in our season unveiling. So, to get us started, here's a preview of their very special upcoming 85th season.
What's an orchestra for, anyway? After 85 years of music making by the Tuscarawas Philharmonic, folks in the area can answer that question. The Philharmonic exists to bring the excitement of live symphonic music, with all its sonic thrills, emotional highs, and profound depths, as found in a 400-year-old tradition that stretches from the music of Johann Sebastian Bach to John Williams and beyond. After a year of not playing for a live audience or hearing live music in a concert hall, we have all missed that experience. The opportunity to gather as a community around great art and great entertainment. To celebrate our 85th season, the Philharmonic reminds us what an orchestra is for. Well, there's gotta be Beethoven. Last season, we missed the opportunity to observe his 250th anniversary and recall what makes his music so indispensable. So we'll open this season with a healthy serving of classic Beethoven, including the epic Fifth Symphony. We'll also go on other symphonic journeys with the music of Sergei Rachmaninoff, Paul Hindemith, and Gustav Mahler. What else is an orchestra for? Every year, the Tuscarawas region gets an orchestra for Christmas, as the Philharmonic presents classic seasonal music found in Handel's Immortal Messiah, and wrapped up in a bow in the Yuletide celebration, with a chorus full of happy kids and everything. And the Philharmonic will continue to bring to the area phenomenal talent, such as pianists Peter Takash and the incandescent Orion Weiss, and feature our own shining star, Laura Barquette, as the soprano soloist in the heavenly conclusion of Mahler's Fourth Symphony. What's an orchestra for? It's to thrill, ennoble, energize, elevate, scintillate, raise the roof, open the window, lift the spirits, race the pulse, and slow us down to savor each breath, each beat of the heart. To make us cry and to make us laugh. And even to swing a little. The final concert is a celebration of my 25 years on the podium of the Tuscarawas Philharmonic, and I'll be joined by friends for a tuneful toast that will not be complete without some really great laughs.
It's really hard to describe the emotions that a live orchestra can stir up inside you. The Tuscarawas Philharmonic is truly a local treasure, and I encourage everyone to take advantage and experience one of their concerts. We've stuffed so much into our upcoming season. We have four artists who between them have accumulated 23 Grammy Awards. Think about that, 23 Grammy Awards. We also have artists who are Dove Award winners, even a Guinness World Record holder. We have artists that have toured all over the world, and even a few from other parts of the world. We have a show that is a timeless classic for the whole family and shows that will tell true stories that are going to inspire you. We have shows that will make you ask, how did they do that? We even have a return of Broadway. And we have royalty coming to our stage. Oh, and we have shows that are going to make you laugh. I mean, like, really laugh. Like, make your sides hurt kind of laugh. Now, something to keep in mind, with so many shows this season, and we know you're gonna wanna see them all, if you purchase six or more shows, you save $10 per ticket. That savings can really add up, so be sure to take advantage. All right, I'm getting ahead of myself. Are you ready to see what shows are coming? Well, let's get started. Right after, a word from our sponsor.
Good evening, I'm Scott Robinson, Executive Director of the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation. And on behalf of the Foundation's Board of Directors, we're proud to partner with the Performing Arts Center at Kent State University Tuscarawas, a true jewel of our community. The mission of the Foundation is to enhance the quality of life in our area by making charitable grants to deserving nonprofit organizations. We recognize the importance of the arts as a vital component of what makes our community better. The Performing Arts Center's commitment to excellence, history of bringing world-class entertainment to our region, and dedication to arts education are all shining examples of their impact on our community. And we're thrilled to be the season sponsor for their new 2021-2022 season.
Thanks to the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation for the recognition and support of our efforts here at the Performing Arts Center. We'd also like to thank our platinum sponsor, Alanovis, our series sponsors, First Federal, Aqua Blue Chemical, and Rodriguez's House of Stones, and our official media partner, Western Reserve Public Media. These businesses are not only making an investment in the Performing Arts Center, they are making an investment in our community, and we genuinely appreciate their support. Now, are you ready to find out the shows? Are you sure? Okay, I've kept you in suspense long enough. Tonight, we're simply going to work through the calendar with our first show coming September 9th. Here we go.
When I wake up, well, you know I'm going to be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, well, you know I'm going to be the man who goes along with you. When I'm drinking, well, you know I'm gonna be the man who's drinking next to you. When I haver, well, you know I'm gonna be the man who's havering to you. But I wouldn't walk 500 miles and I wouldn't just to be the man who walks 1,000 miles to fall down at your door. When I'm working, well, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man who's working hard for you. When the money comes in for the work I do, I'll bring every penny home to you.
The pleasure of growing up in America before the lawyers took it over and ruined it on us. And yeah. In my day, if a kid fell off the monkey bars and chipped a bone in his arm, that was tragic, but it was funny to the rest of us. You know? Certainly wasn't reasons to take the monkey bars off the playgrounds. We all did dumb things. That's how you learn not to do dumb things. C.S. Lewis said suffering was God's megaphone. That's right. You do dumb things, it hurts, and then you learn not to do it. But we're the most painted versus, I'll give you an example. When I was 12, someone told me to get a ball jar, canning jar. Find some dry ice, put it in the jar, put the lid on it. So I said, what's gonna happen? They said, it's gonna blow up. And I said, cool. Where do I get dry ice at? And they said, the ice cream man. So one day I heard the ice cream man coming down my street. I run out with one of my mother's canning jars and I ask, you got any dry ice? He said, what you gonna do with it? I said, I'm gonna put it in this jar, I'm gonna put the lid on it, and it's gonna explode. Ice cream man says, oh, here's your dry ice. That's the America I grew up in.
Waitress, the hit Broadway musical with songs by Grammy Award winner Sara Bareilles, is a little slice of heaven. New York Magazine calls it sweet, sassy, passionate, and delightful. Waitress, the hilarious hit Broadway musical. Order up.
As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away. We found love right where we are. Maybe we found love right where we are.
It begins at Pearl Harbor with Chief Petty Officer John Finn scrambling to fight off Japanese dive bombers on the Day of Infamy, a desperate deed for which he would receive the Medal of Honor.
Well, I'm madder than hell. I wasn't being courageous. All I was doing was I pissed off.
The actor Stephen Lang, best known for his role in the Hollywood blockbuster Avatar, portrays 8 Medal of Honor recipients in the one-man play, Beyond Glory, using their own words as recorded in this oral history.
I deserve it, the U.S. Army!
The stories of uncommon valor change with each man, but in one way, they're all the same.
You're being asked, not ordered, but just asked by the fact that you're there to do stuff that no soldier really should have to do. That's why it's the Medal of Honor, because if you didn't do it, nobody would hold it against you.
Infantry! Ha!
Lang has performed Beyond Glory hundreds of times to troops around the world and in community theaters across the country.
I never could have anticipated that this play would give me what it's given me.
Thank you. Good night.
This is good stuff, right? And that was just through November. And we have so much more in store for you. Now, after 10 years, there's nothing we love more than being part of family traditions. When you build memories with family and friends around a shared experience, those memories last a lifetime. Those traditions are even more special around the holidays. And in addition to the Tuscarawas Philharmonic's annual holiday show, which typically sells out, we have two shows that are guaranteed to get you and your family into the holiday spirit.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
Well, our story began on Broadway with the original Broadway production of Jersey Boys.
We won the Tony Award. We were everywhere.
We wanted to take what we did on Broadway all across the country.
Going on the road like a rock and roll band.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
It's that time of year when the world falls in love. Every song here seems to say,
lovers stroll along the parkway as they wander hand in hand. It must be Christmas, Christmas again.
Earlier, I mentioned that we have four artists who between them have accumulated 23 Grammy Awards. Amy Grant was one of those artists. She's won six. The other three artists are in the second half of our season, and kicking off 2022 is an artist who has won 15.
Get down, boys,
Do. My purpose in life is to help unlock the greatness in others. How do I do that? I created something I call the Unauthorized Biography Series, where I tell the life stories of the world's greatest leaders, heroes, all through biographical rap songs, repackaging history through hip-hop. You see, we live in a world where more and more now, all the breaking news is heartbreaking news. Or hateful views, racial feuds, and we gotta watch out because we turn into what we tune into. That's why I look to the greats to understand what it took to be great. Now as I perform and share these stories, my question is always, what can we learn? What can they teach us about leadership, community, greatness?
oceans apart, day after day, and I slowly go insane. I hear your voice on the line, but it doesn't stop the pain. If I see you next, never. How can we say forever? Wherever you go, whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes, or how my heart breaks, I will.
At the Performing Arts Center, we take great pride in our educational outreach efforts. In a typical year, we are able to reach close to 10,000 local students and offer impactful learning experiences. In addition to our Class Act series, where students experience educational programming here in our theater, we'll continue taking artists out into schools for a more up-close and personal experience. We wouldn't be able to do any of these without financial support from community organizations like the Dover Exchange Club, regional foundation grants, and donations from individuals like you to our very own education fund. I've got a few friends who have something they want to tell you. Now, back to the shows. Remember those four artists and those 23 Grammy Awards? We've already seen three of them. Amy Grant with 6, Ricky Skaggs has 15, and Richard Marx has 1 Grammy Award. Now, if you've done the math, that brings us to 22. The next Grammy winner is actually a group and is also part of our educational outreach efforts. This will be the first time we have ever taken Grammy-winning musicians out into our local schools. Here's our final group of shows, starting off with our final Grammy Award winner, Third Coast Percussion. Thank you.
for Irish dance. Epic. Spectacular. Unmissable.
This is Velocity Irish Dance.
Stuff on Broadway, you've come to the right place. Summer, the Donna Summer Musical. The new, sparkling, must-see musical of the moment, where every night the audience reaches a fever pitch. Summer, the Donna Summer Musical.
My name is Eleanor Dubinsky. Welcome to my music.
Turn around, turn around, turn around.
St. Louis, Missouri, and my life has, by choice and by luck, been very international. I speak French, I speak Spanish, I speak Portuguese.
Je pense à toi.
Those languages naturally come into my songwriting, so my music comes from my life. We especially like to speak to younger communities because we understand what it's like to be different.
I let go. This is the way I'm gonna grow. I let go, I let go, I let go. Caught in the rain.
Escucha la música, listen to the music. Escucha la música, listen to the music. Escucha la música, listen to the music. Escucha la música.
In 1964, television viewers tuned in to the Ed Sullivan Show to see the American debut of a British group called The Beatles. And the world was never the same. Featuring music from The Rolling Stones, The Kinks, The Beatles and more, The British Invasion relives the hits that changed the world. This immersive multimedia concert experience takes you on a musical journey front and center back to the 60s. They came, they sang, they conquered. The British Invasion, live on stage.
I'm sitting here in our mezzanine section, which is a great place to watch any show. What would you say if I told you you could have a seat here or in our dress circle for only $15? Well, you can. Thanks to First Federal Community Bank and their investment in our community, we're pleased to introduce to you the First Fed 15. This package of 10 shows guarantees you 10 nights out to see 10 diverse, engaging, and honestly, just really fun shows, all for just $15 per ticket. That's more than 50% off the regular ticket price. The First Fed 15 can be purchased online or by calling or stopping into our box office. Simply ask for the First Fed 15. On November 27th, 2020, we celebrated our 10th anniversary. Like most things in 2020, that celebration didn't happen quite as we planned. However, we're not one to let a good milestone go to waste, so we're moving ahead with our celebration and are thrilled to have a very special guest who will join us to celebrate our 10th, well, our 11th. Anyways, we're gonna have a big party in November, so make sure you get your tickets before they're gone.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you. Here's a, very kind. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. Here's a, thank you. Good night, everybody.
Thank you. No, that's fine.
Thank you, that's very kind. Hey, have you gotten this phenomenon called binge watching, where you watch a whole season of a TV show in one sitting? Okay, all right. So how does this work? What, you come home from work Friday night, what? You put on a pair of Depends, you sit on the couch till Monday pretty much? Maybe binge eat while you're binge watching? See, that's another thing that embarrasses me as an American. Competitive eating is now a sport in this country. They cover it on ESPN. This is the only country in the world where eating 300 chicken wings makes you an athlete now. I mean, don't you find that ironic? Competitive eating is a sport, yet somehow we still can't quite accept soccer. You know? It doesn't really seem like a real sport like eating. How many, do you like soccer? How many watch soccer? A lot of Americans think soccer is boring, but I'll tell you something. I watched that last round of the World Cup. For the first half hour, the score was, 0-0? I turned my head away for just 1 hour, and boom, it was 1-0. Well, you know, now there's a lot of talk that these World Cup athletes are also on performance-enhancing drugs. You know this performance-enhancing drug. We need to get realistic. See, I think every team should be allowed one steroid freak. You're watching a baseball game, top of the ninth, bases loaded, bring out Mongo. Ah! I mean, guy comes out, holding the bat with one hand, ah! A one-handed home run. How exciting would that be to watch? I mean, you're watching the Tour de France, right? No, look, hey. Everybody's going 35 miles an hour. Here comes Mongo. Oh, 85, 90 miles an hour on a bicycle, eyes on fire. Who wouldn't watch that?
Can you believe it? Jay Leno in New Philadelphia, Ohio, coming November 20th. Get your tickets now before they're gone. Speaking of tickets, you want to make note of the following dates. Performing Arts Center members will have first access to tickets beginning Monday, June 14th. There's still time to become a PAC member and get in the front of the line. Find a PAC representative before you leave tonight or call us in the office and we'll get you all the information you need. On Thursday, June 24th, packages of 6 or more will be available to everyone. Remember, if you purchase 6 or more shows, you'll save $10 per ticket. Now, individual shows will go on sale for everyone on Monday, June 28th. And for anyone who purchases tickets before August 2nd, you'll automatically save $5 per ticket. So buy early and buy often. Also, before you leave tonight, be sure to take a season brochure with you. Finally, after a long wait, our seats are here, ready, just waiting for you. We can't wait to welcome you back. Let's make some more memories together.
We've been waiting a long time for this moment. Are you ready? Beginning this fall, the pack is back. Coming to New Philadelphia, Amy Grant, Jay Leno, Richard Marx, Easton Corbin, Dennis DeYoung, Ricky Skaggs, plus Broadway shows, Waitress in Summer, the Donna Summer Musical, and many more. Tickets are on sale now. For more information, visit kent.edu/tuskpack.